Around the World with MS World. I'm Dr. Daniel Cantor here with Wendy from MS World, as well as with Dr. Alan Bowling, who's a physician associate at the Colorado Neurological Institute. You talked about integrative medicine. What is that?
I think integrative medicine, I think, often gets a bad rap because people think it's sort of woo-woo alternative medicine. In contrast, it's actually evidence-based approach to conventional medicine plus unconventional medicine plus lifestyle, and then doing that in a way to treat disease, but also to maintain health and prevent disease, and also for clinicians to do that in a way that's supportive of the patient and not the old school paternalistic model.
And you have a lot of fans back home, but you have one of your fans right here. So Wendy, what questions do you have for Dr. Bowling?
Well, Dr. Bowling and I have known each other almost over 20 years now. And as I say, I really love to refer your book to people with the alternative therapies. In these 20 years, are you seeing a lot of changes? Are patients starting to buy on to both using the DMTs as well as going with alternative therapy?
Yeah, you know, that's been a common conversation topic at the meeting here this time, because I started on this 20 plus years ago, and the first time I did this conference at this meeting was Sunday morning at about 7 in the morning, and there were four or five people and three left after the first hour, and now there's lots of interest. People are trying to figure out how to incorporate this into their practice, and, you know, that started about 10 years ago with health professionals, but starting 20 years ago, patients with MS really appreciated having the information. So I didn't actually think it was going to happen in my career, and I'm still in my career, and there's been gigantic change on the patient side and also professional side.
Wendy, what kind of questions do you see from people with MS about integrated medicine or complementary alternative medicine? There's lots of different terminology.
Right. Well, it's interesting. The legalized marijuana is one of the biggest, and Colorado was one of the first states, so I know it's very available there. In speaking with other physicians, when they speak about medical marijuana, they'll fill the room with patients who are interested in information. So now that you're in Colorado, you must see a big upswing in this.
There's been interest, yeah, so we've had medical marijuana for about 20 years, recreational for a few years, and yeah, that's probably one of the most common questions, conversation topics, and then I've devoted a lot of my past 1 to 2 years of my career to really go into the 25,000 articles that are out there about cannabis and then try to distill that down to something that's digestible for a healthcare professional and for people with MS, and I'll say there's free information on that on my website, and there's a copy right there, but everyone please liberally use it, whether you're a health professional or someone with MS.
Well, I want to thank you so much, Dr. Bowling. I want to thank you, Wendy, for joining us, and everyone back home, thank you for joining us yet again.
Thank you so much for squeezing us in.
Thanks for inviting me.